Spitfires. This would be a really awesome battle of bricks. Christian says you have less frame rates on the ground since Civil Day 6 as soon as you wheels leave the ground on the FPS and back. That's interesting. We had something very similar yesterday on the live stream when we were attacking other aircraft shooting at the TKS. But we were a major airport in the USA, so I put it down to that. Okay, so I'm going to make a left bank, and pretty soon, well, I can see directly beneath me, it's the, ignore that. Obviously, where it is. Well, we discovered as well at the end of the stream last week that this area was a photogrammetry area. That's strange, I just didn't expect it to be. Just because it's not a main city in the USA, is it? Obviously, it's not a small city, but there are perhaps larger ones you would expect. But this is White Oak Village Shopping Retail Center that you can see directly beneath us. It doesn't look like the satellite went over on a particularly busy day, given that the car park looks rather empty. And just get back in the flight deck, and if we can get up to that too, I can set the trim.
Who's up to me?
So I think now you can just see over the instrument panel, there's a hint of the James River, which we're going to meet up with in a couple of seconds. So you guys all hopefully had a good weekend. What have you been up to? Have you done any great flights this weekend? Let me know. I still love the detail that comes with the photogrammetry. Do you remember at the end of last week, if you did see last week's stream, right at the end, as we were flying over central Richmond, then there was the construction site, wasn't there? There was a construction site there, obviously, where the building it is that they were building, and it looked absolutely phenomenal. And there it is. There is the I-95. So, good, about 2,000 feet, whoops, level are off. And the fact that I can use my weapon to be happy with this. I do think, as pretty as everything does look with the weather presets, I think if you can use my weapon, I do think it does look a little bit more realistic, particularly when looking out to the horizon and see the weather is coming. Sunday, there must be less traffic. There isn't that much traffic in the road, is there? I'll tell you one thing I haven't seen a great deal of during this this series, flying in America. And that is the sorry, I've just got the feeling that I was quite good. Just wanted to introduce that. Yeah, one thing I haven't seen very much of on this series. here in the UK, there's wind farms everywhere, and not even just full sets of farms. Occasionally, you'll just get the odd two or three clustered together. So, with all that space that America has got, sure, you could push up some wind farm. Be nice and green for the it's Patrick, have you found the Orbex series? Yeah, go and grab yourself that, of course. It's a bell from Orbex, so it's high quality stuff. You know it's high quality stuff. So this is apparently, it's the Commerce Road Industrial Area. I don't know what they do down there, but there's a McDonald's. I believe this is McDonald's, right there on the junction. So there's our first McDonald's of the stream. That didn't take long, did it? Mark, you overstressed your cup. Robert, you're working all weekend. No thanks for you. The last flight was into Doncaster, Sheffield. What a great choice of airport. I bet there was no other live traffic there, was there? Michael Jones, they're mostly on the West Coast, I believe. Well, I could understand that. It was the West Coast. Like here in the UK, the West Coast bears the brunt of the weather, doesn't it? Now, I like the name of this little pond that we're flying directly over right now. This is called the Polishing Pond. What on earth did he do there?
That's right.
Michael, wind farms are so loud people don't like them near their houses. Well, that's fine in America, there's so much land. Come to the UK, you can't swing a dead cat without hitting a house. There's just houses absolutely everywhere. That's why they're so darn expensive. Right, so down here we've got a little place. Magic providing us with the range of airports in our vicinity. Thank you, Dr. Magic. So the South Park Mall is what you're looking at directly beneath us. Again, must have been taken first thing on a Monday morning. Not many cars in the parking lot. This is the Appomattox River, by the way. I love some of the names that the rivers have. I usually have to read them twice before attempting a pronunciation because some of them are tongue twisters. Christian asks, wonder what's cheaper? Using the heater in the winter and paying for that? Or just leave the simulator running without max cap and let the GPU do the heating work? Wonder if the results are the same. I tell you what, Christian, the office that I had converted where I am now in the house, because I got kicked out of my office upstairs, and probably the girls needed a bedroom. Hang on just one second. I'm just negotiating my way through this junction, working out where, which way we're meant to be going. Where are we going? I'm taking my eye off the ball here, one second. Because there is a junction, and yeah, okay, so... The I-95 hooked up the I-85, and I need to make sure we're on the correct route. But we are. Although, I am looking for some sort of landmarks to check. I'm not 100% convinced at the moment. Oh, hang on. Yeah, here we are. There's the railroad. Yeah, that's fine. I know where we are. We are directly above Hampstead Rail Brenkville Bearings. Whatever they do. So I've now got a converted office, which didn't have part of the central heating. So I bought an external heater, an electric heater for the winter months. And since the simulator came out, I've not used it. Or I've used it very, very rarely. So yeah, it does kick out a lot of heat. Mark, you've got to get off. You're off to the Yorkshire Wildlife Park tomorrow. Great place. First day of the school holidays tomorrow. Good luck with that. Magna on Tuesday, so we need to get stuff sorted. We will enjoy the rest of the flight. That sounds like a good day out for you and the kids, and Mark. So enjoy that, my friend. Yorkshire Wildlife. My kids have been right at home there, they've fitted with the animals. So, there's a petrol station down there, I've just got the name of it. It's called Salem Market. That's coming up just there. Salem Market. Whenever I hear the name Salem, it takes me back to my youth, and I used to watch a girl called Sabrina the Teenage Witch, and I think my cat was called Salem. Trevor, any possible reasons why Microsoft Flight Simulator sometimes removes half of the multiplayer people? To be honest with you, I have no idea. I don't know if anyone on the stream does and can enlighten us, but I'm afraid not. There's a whole host of hotels coming up. Just here, we've got Red Roof Inn, we've got the Holiday Inn, we've got the Hampton Inn, we've got the Days Inn. So this must just be a popular restaurant. I'm not quite sure what's around here touristy wise. But then again, I would say it'd be a great place for HGV drivers to stop, but this doesn't look like it's particularly designed for that kind of place, does it? Start to look. This is the first sim update since. Sorry, this is the first I-95 flight since sim update number 6. And I don't know if it's just me, but I think everything looks much greener. The colours appear to me to be much, much more vibrant. Would I say that's realistic? Too sure of it, to be honest. I mean, I never thought it looked bad before. It could just be me. I don't know if it's just me. And that's how I think it's looking, but has anyone else noticed perhaps more vibrant colours in their simulator since the sim update number 6? It's Patrick. You're trying to get the Orbex stuff. It's not letting you purchase it. That's strange. They make you down on the server updates. It's a Sunday night, which is a good time for them to do stuff like this. And to be fair, actually, isn't Orbex based in Australia? So it's a little of the night for them. LA Kids 143 Daylight Saving Time ends here on November 7th, so it'll be dark an hour earlier. Well, technically it won't be. It won't be dark an hour earlier. It'll still go dark at exactly the same time, but our clocking of the time as humans changes, doesn't it? So, to all intents and purposes, yes, it'll be dark an hour earlier. But how it will affect where the sun is, particularly in relation to the time that I stream these flights here in the USA, that will make no difference. The Warwick Swamp is... I think we just passed the Warwick Swamp. Have we passed it or have we not gone there just yet? Let's keep an eye on that. I think we may have passed that bit too, actually, the Warwick Swamp. Christian says, Gavin, you live in the UK where every day is grey and rainy. Of course you think. There will be much more colours and greener greens in other countries. Global warming means actually we're getting lots and lots of beautiful hot days. But you're right, we've still got lots of grey days too. Beef3D, you are welcome to join us. Obviously you will not look like... you will expect here on the live stream because I would need to have the aircraft and mic here to be different on the screen in the survey, but by all means, please do come and fly with us. I have no idea where you are. So we're just having a look as I go down here. Okay. So we're passing over a little village called Carson Village. Look at bright red roofs, that's a dead VFR giveaway for anyone looking at that. I have no idea what it is. Looks like a truck stop of some description if you zoom onto Google Maps. There's the Carson Volunteer Fire Department as well. Yeah, I'd say that looks like a firehouse, wouldn't you? Quite nicely rendered. Just says in that trillion. Now looking straight ahead, there seems to be very little sort of built-up area. And we could be in for just some nice long stretches of forestry and greenery, which is fine. That's exactly how the series started, isn't it, when we left Maine? The Carson Safety Rest Area is coming up just here, as you can see. In fact, is that there? Or is that one a bit further on? That might be a little bit further on. So if anyone wants to join us, as Nick has very kindly just let us know, we've got Kilo, Echo, Mike, Victor, Airport coming up. Get yourself on the North Europe server and come and join us. Luanti Creek is what you see beneath us at the moment. If anyone wants to skip ahead on their Google Maps or whatever it is you're using to track your flights, what's the next major city that we hit? Obviously, we've left Richmond. We've got got Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen. Look at that, look at the news on that. And Hampton Inn Story. Crank. And Pittsburgh area. A little rest stop. And look at all the HGVs in the car park. Michael Jones 420 says, you have hardly ever found a good cup of coffee at a rest stop. No, this is true. See, over here in the UK, at all the service stations, we don't call them rest stops, we call them service stations. All the service stations over here, they're now awash with Costa coffees and Starbucks. Very few small independent little shops, which is what I'm seeing here as we're going down. It's quite nice. Small independent little shops and things. But no, everything's just major corporations over here. Carter Service Centre down there. And the Galey Baptist Church. It's just there. I do like the way that farmland is depicted in the simulator. I think that, particularly flying over the farmlands in England and things, and of course America, I think the scenery does an amazing job. You can see all the marks, you can get the feel of the fact that down there it looks like a real field. Dr. Magic Little Chef. Are they still going? I thought they'd gone kaput. Thought they disappeared a while ago. That's strange, isn't it? I wonder what that is down there. I can see it. I can see it on the on Google Maps, but it's not letting me know what it is. It's like a secret stash away place, isn't it? Nick says, motor services with Burger King. Oh yeah, Burger King. Burger King's at every service station. And you know what, I prefer McDonald's to Burger King. There's a whole other discussion we could have. Yeah, I prefer McDonald's to Burger King. And if I get to a service station, I need a service station, I want some food, I'll keep driving. Usually past all the Burger King ones, I'll find McDonald's. Now, what is Airport Mir that I can see coming up? Apparently there's an Airport Mir directly beneath us, according to Google Maps. I'm pretty certain there's no airport down there. It's surrounded by trees. That's not a sort of place I'd be looking to land, even in an emergency. I'd be picking a field over there somewhere. So, that's a little bit strange. Any hint of an airfield? Again, comparing it with Google Maps, that little jagged waterway, that looks really good. Are we still in Virginia? I don't think we've crossed any state lines yet. It's Patrick, you've got a few more megabytes left of your SIM update. Yeah, it's not the fastest thing in the world, is it, updating the simulator? Oh, Mr. Whippies, who's just said that? The Wimpies, I see. I had a birthday party there once when I was a kid. At least I think it is. It might not be mine. They had a mascot as well, didn't they? Freakish thing. I think it was only about 5 or 6 when they went out of business here in the UK. Oh, I think we've just hit an updraft. back in and see how that climbs through. So I've heard reports as well since 7/6 that turbulence effects have really been affecting airlines like the A320. Has anybody else had such problems? If you have, let me know. Judy, you wonder when we'll get the first hot fix for SIP update number 6. That's an interesting question. What would it fix? What would be number 1 for you guys for it to fix? Nick, you've still got a Wimpy on your high street. Have they not gone bust? Oh, actually, I think I seem to recall that they did come back, didn't they? Because I think they only went out of business. Did they go out of business fully here in the UK? But then they brought them back. Wayne's here. Wayne, you're going to be celebrating Trafalgar Day tonight. Splice the main birds. Dark Fury, has anyone seen a Woolworths? Do they exist in the USA still? They certainly don't exist over here, do they? That was the sort of start and demise of the rather large high street chain stores, wasn't it? God bless Woolworths. Now, somewhere, there we go. The corrections department, which is a posh term for prison, is over there. Ooh, hello. What's that? Oh, that's Grenville Correctional Facility. So, that's an even bigger prison. So, I don't know. According to Google Maps, baby prison, big boy prison. Interesting shape, that, isn't it? For all that. Is it hexagonal? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, hexagonal shape. Dr. Magic, you've got a Wimpy as well. Oh, look, they must have come back. I just thought they'd gone out of fashion. Rico87, good evening, sir. Hope you're well. So Nick, which airport's that? Kilo India X-ray Alpha is coming up. As is a long shot right on the bend. For anyone who's feeling particularly religious this Sunday evening, the Chapel Hill Baptist Church is just down there. Oh, Michael Jones, of course, Toys R Us has also gone. Another major store. It's Patrick. Nick has just told us, I think the newest one is Kilo India X-ray Alpha. Dark Fury chirping with a proper Yorkshire cry of shame Netto went. It's Scandinavian for value. Netto may have gone, but IKEA's here to stay. There's lots of churches around here. St. John Kojic Church? One of the things they do need to fix is propellers of other aircraft. They look rather strange, just rather stationary. Dark Fury, yeah. Everyone remembers Netto. The 8P for a can of beans. And everyone thought that was ridiculous at the time, didn't they? But then, can't you get that in Asda now for the same price? So, just looking for the... yeah, just looking now, what's coming up next? I believe it's a place called Emporia. Emporia is up next of the big major city. Oh, I don't know if it even counts as a city. It's nowhere near big enough for a city here in the USA. Your local pilot, do I do vaccine? I do vaccine. I am a vaccine doer. Careful here that I actually followed the correct road. There are two.
Emporia.
The right-hand one is the I-95. That comes to the major junction that you see up there. Oh, the first Walmart supercenter that I've seen. Sorry, no, it's the second, isn't it? Second Walmart supercenter. It's just there. Rico 87, we've seen two so far. Two Walmarts. That's four drinks. Virginia DMVM or a customer service center. Wow, that looks great fun working there. But the Whole Plate Grill and Cafe sounds quite inviting. Yeah, do you not think that the colours look so much more vibrant at Civil Day 6? Or is it just me? My mind playing tricks on me. J-Hog, do you know what? That is an incredibly astute observation of you to say, you know, we're drunk by this time or something. I haven't seen a golf course yet. That river looks rather lucky, doesn't it? Normally we're seeing golf courses left, right and centre, but no. No, we're not. Mm-hmm. Big golfers territory. Anyway, the Greensville High School is what you're seeing beneath us. That's why you've got the running track and the tennis courts. Stop off at Red Wines International, which is just over here. That sounds like a great place. Should we just go and land in the field over there? Suddenly I've seen an increase in traffic as well, that must be why. So flat, and as I pan around, you can see there's no hillsides, no mountains, no nothing as far as we can see at the moment. Christopher Shaw, good evening, sir. Hope you're well. Christian says the South States don't do golf, they do NASCAR. Nick, is that the perfect stop for you? Are you a red wine man? I prefer rosé myself. I like the sweet stuff. A nice sweet rosé wine is a great way to spend an evening. Watching some rubbish on TV is a way to unwind. This, of course, is a good way to. So you can see, I don't know if it's meant to be a firebreak line or whether it's meant to be a power line trail. But you can see the gap in the forestry. It would seem like a strange place to have a firebreak line. It's not going to take too much, particularly when you've got the road there as well. Pico, it's a 7. Sangria. Yeah, well, that's a shout as well. Wow, we need to stop here. Okay, so what we've got here at this little service station, we have got the Pilot's Travel Centre. God knows what we can buy there. We've got Love's Travel Store. And we've got an IHOP. That is the first IHOP that I have seen since starting this stream, or this series of streams. There you go. So are IHOPs much bigger down in the Southern States compared to up north? Oh, Nick, now you're talking my language. Nice Blossom Hill Rosé. Good stuff. I can't endorse that here. They're not big. Jayhawk, try Squid Games. Isn't that that series that's on Netflix at the moment? I saw it advertised the other day and I thought, well, maybe when the wife's busy, because I don't think that's the kind of thing she wants to watch. I don't mind stuff like that. Survival, fantasy, and all that sort of stuff. But series that mess with your mind a little bit. Now, we're just watching down here. I'm seeing all these shadows of these trees sort of spawn in as we get near. I've not noticed this happening before. That's kind of annoying, actually, to tell you the truth. Wouldn't bother me in the A320, of course, I wouldn't be looking, but for pilots that like to do this sort of flying on a regular basis, that's annoying. E85, good evening. There's no hills, that's why there's no golf. Fair point. Christian, I say one glass, but I mean one bottle. No, one glass. You just haven't seen the size of the glass. Your local pilot, I was thinking something very similar. This is a huge woodland area, but I think now we've just crossed over the border into North Carolina. Now, I was looking for some sort of toll, not a toll booth, but, you know, state line thing, but there isn't one, so I don't know if anyone on the stream who's more au fait with American customs. Every border crossing we've seen so far has always had a border control crossing, but that one just didn't, which is very strange. So I don't know what that's all about. Are you just free to cross those lines, no questions asked? I'm just going to gain a little bit of altitude, because if I'm completely honest with you, there looks like very, very little going on between now and wherever the next main city is. Of course, to keep us entertained, we've got a fantastic community of you guys. And always fun watching an aircraft fly inverted and crash into woodland beneath us. Always rescue it. Oh, fair. Anyway, whatever that is there, it is Clement Mechanical Building. It's very easy to get your bearings now when the landscape is this bland. You see a massive white rectangular building, such as whatever that is over there, and a quick zoom out on Google Maps and you know instantly what it is, because there's, nothing else it can be. side of the road is the crossing just there. I'm seeing a lot of these shadows sort of creeping at the last minute. I'm hoping everyone else has seen something similar on their simulator if you're flying alongside. Hellake is the bigger well-known golf resort in North Carolina, and South Carolina are usually closer to the ocean. She Fleming, what mods am I using? The game looks amazing. No, absolutely none that you can see at the moment. This is all default. All default stuff. And the river coming up is the, what is it? The Roanoke River, I think it is, the Roanoke River. That's what I was saying about the farmland. You can see the direction that the farmlands have been ploughed. Really great stuff. I believe it's, what's the name of the area that we're coming up to now? Is it Southwestern? I had made that up. South Weldon, South Weldon. So, as you can see, a little bit more populated here. You knew as soon as you saw the river that there was going to be some village of some description, didn't you? That's how all settlements begin their early lives. Darren Gardner, hello my friend. How's your weekend been? Yeah, little things like that. You can see sort of, it's not a racing track, is it? But it almost looks like a man-made, or rather a child-made, racing track, a dirt track for bikers and things. Picking those up here in the sim looks really good. And I can obviously see that on Google Maps as well. Darren, no, it's not a new livery. My EasyJet Sim Pilot custom livery for the DB20, which I normally fly on the stream. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll not spoil it for you, Darren. Go back to the start of the stream after we've finished and just go and watch. And you'll understand now, then, why I'm flying this. LA Kids, the last half of the TCAS stream yesterday was a hoot. It was something a little bit different to the norm, wasn't it? I really hope that comes to the experimental version of the A320 very, very soon. Because, it's a big thing. Now, Halifax Northampton Regional Airport. Is where we're coming up to, and after our hours flying on this stream, that's where we will be touching down and leaving our aircraft for another week. Now, we've got to navigate there. What we're going to do is continue down the I-95, and then we turn left at the Burger King. So the airport in question is over here, I think, and that's going to be our end point for this Sunday evening stream. So here's the junction. We've got Exxon, which here in the UK is called Esso, I think. Here's the Burger King. We're going to make a hard left. As we say goodbye to the I-95 for a little bit. Tell you what, it really does look great this night, doesn't it? And then I'm going to be looking for what it looks like. Almost looks on Google Maps like a row of solar panels, actually. They don't appear to have materialised, however, in Bing Maps. The airfield, of course, though, is just there. That's going to be our home for another week. LA Kids Mini Dirt Dirt Racing Tracks in the South, the result of the all-time whiskey buzz. And here we are. This is Halifax Northampton Regional Airfield. A nice small airfield for us to finish our stream on today. So if those of you who are flying want to go down and get yourself in. There might just be enough room for us all to park up. I'm looking at the speed at which some of you are making your approach. I'm not convinced. By the way, Harrison Ford, that's a taxiway down there you appear to be aiming to land on. Oh, good call, you've gone around. So green, isn't it? I don't think this is England. No, there's too much space. It couldn't possibly be England. Your local pilot says the tower at this airfield must be very confused. I don't know how much. I mean, it's a small regional airport, isn't it? Decent length runway, though, looking at it.
Yeah, rambling.
I bet it can house some decent length small airliners. I was just looking, actually. I'll tilt the wing. Then I'll spot a wing sock, get an idea of the runway in use. Oh, yeah, okay. So we are going for the right runway. I can see two of my piloting colleagues ahead of us going straight in. We'll form up behind them. Not the most conventional of approaches, but it's going to get us down there. Whoever's landing in front of me, that looks like a great landing, just off centre line a little bit, but who cares? How long is this runway? Is it long enough to touch down on? That was a rather long landing, but we are down. Up the back end of the Cessna. Great stuff. What a glorious day. I don't think we've seen any clouds, have we, whilst we've been flying today? small little generic airfield. Or regional airfield. I think once again Isobo's done a great job. I do think that the ground textures from Rex really do add to a lot of the default airports here in the sim. So the ground textures that you're seeing are provided by Rex, and they affect all of the default airports. And as you can see, the taxi lines and things, they just look a little bit worn compared to the default Isobo ones, which literally looked like everything had been freshly painted. Barry says, sorry, that was your back end. You've run out of fuel.